and really creating a hometown advantage. It hasn't necessarily worked in the last couple of home games, but they are creating quite a disruption for visiting squads here at the Pack, and it's been a whole lot of fun for Warrior fans to witness this. A lot of teams have elected to take their whole bench, take all the seating to the baseline, but the Mustangs at this point are holding fast and strong right at their own bench on the south end of the Pack. So the OUA West currently stands like this, with the Windsor Lancers with a record of 14-3. Lakehead is 12-5 just behind them. McMaster at 10-7. Brock at 6-11. Guelph and Laurier at 5-12. And then the Warriors are right there at 3-14. And Western Mustangs at 2-15. We get set to send it down courtside for the playing of the national anthem. And the crowd rises to their feet for the national anthem here at the physical activities complex on the campus of the University of Waterloo. And a little bit of feedback for our singer who is set to go. Starting lineup for the Western Mustangs under sixth-year head coach Brad Campbell. Campbell will be starting number four, Elliot Dooley, a first-year guard and Ottawa kinesiology major. Number seven, Ryan Higgins, a second-year 6'4 guard in the social science program at Fergus. Number eight, Quinn Henderson, a 6'4 guard in his third year out of Dundas. Number 10, Peter Schultes, a 6'5 forward in his third year in social science out of London. Schultes is their star player. And number 12, Greg Morrow, a 6'3 forward in his second year social science major out of London. The assistant coaches are John Curcio, and Kevin Barnes. For the Warriors, under head coach, first-year head coach, Greg Francis. They start number five, Jasper Gill, a 6'1 guard in his second year of eligibility out of Oliver, B.C. in the arts program. Number 24, Wells Davis. Wells, a 6'5 guard in his first year at Mississauga in the arts and business. They start Denim Buchanan, a 6'3 guard in his second year in the arts and business program out of Toronto. Number 13, Mike Kelsby, and Mike, currently in his fourth year of eligibility, a 6'5 guard in the English Literature Master's program here at Waterloo, out of Waterloo. And number 14, Brendan Smith, in his final home game in the black and gold, the 6'7 forward in the nanotechnology program out of Kamloops, B.C. Warriors, again we mentioned, Curry Coleman will not be starting, not eligible to play, and may not play again this season. John Ravenhorst also injured with a, not in the game, injured with a groin injury that persists, and Smith Brendan Smith wins his last tip-off at home. Got over Despreet. Got it to Buchanan. Nice pass intended for Despreet. Didn't quite cut fast enough, the pass from Smith. Keys to the game for the Warriors. Coach France is telling us before the game, playing for Brendan. That's what the focus will be today. They need to play their best in the last game here at home of the regular season. And they need to play with fire. Helsby trapping Morrow in the corner. They get it over to Henderson. Bounces over to Schultes. Schultes one-on-one with Smith. Gets past Smith with a nice move and kisses it off the glass. The crowd on their feet here at the back waiting for the first basket from the field for the Warriors in the ballgame. We've played 45 seconds and the Mustangs lead the Warriors 2-0. Gild at the corner to Buchanan. Up to Helsby. Back over to Buchanan. Wanted to get into Smith. Denham into the paint outside to Wells Davis, whose three ball from the far side is a bit strong. And Schultes comes down with it. Schultes in his third year, a captain on the squad. The ball is stolen by Gill, and a kick ball, he is called. Officials today, Rich Stelick and Mike Hardy. Cutting in is Henderson. That shot is off. Army Morrow with the shot that goes off of a Mustang out of bounds. Get to that third official in just a moment. They get it in to Smith. Kicks it out to Buchanan. Buchanan over to Helsby on the left side, driving in to the baseline. Got it into Smith, and then a push is called. That push is going to go against Morrow, it looks like. That'll be the first team foul on the Mustangs. And the first one on Morrow. Chris Delaney is our third official this afternoon. Keys to the game for the Mustangs as Wells kicks it outside to Helsby. He'll drive baseline, stops. He ran right in to Morrow and then coughs the ball up into Henderson. Driving in on Buchanan. That shot doesn't go. The fight for the loose ball. Higgins is there, and Higgins travels under the basket. Coach Campbell of the Mustangs, had one of the youngest teams in the CIS last season, even younger this season. He says the keys to the game are defensive rebounding, making shots. He says we'll see those shots from this usual contingent of shooters. And his team needs to step up against this Warriors squad. Helsby to the right wing to Wells Davis. Lost the handle. Over to Buchanan. Down right underneath the basket. He banks it in. Crowd can finally take a seat. 2 minutes and 15 seconds into the first quarter, and the game is knotted up at two. Coach Campbell also told us that his squad needs to score over 70 points to be competitive in this ballgame. Higgins driving in, loses the handle. Tried to get it into Schultes, who felt he was fouled. No call and a substitution as George Johnson, a first-year player out of London, replaces Higgins. Gill taking his time, being guarded by Dooley, and then Despreet may be a little too casual, bringing it over midcourt as he lost the handle. It goes out of bounds. Harry Coleman tweeting from the bench just a minute ago, saying he feels very useless not playing, and the Warriors are going to miss him in this ball game against the Mustangs. Played 3 minutes of the first quarter. As Morrow driving in on Smith. Brendan right on him. The little hook doesn't go. Brendan falls to the floor and a jump ball called. Possession arrow heading in the Mustangs' direction. We asked Coach Francis for a story about Brendan, and he said he doesn't really have one in particular he could think of, but he says that Brendan has been integral has been so helpful this season for him, being a new coach with the Warriors and in the OUA, giving him lots of guidance. Here's the shot from Johnson. That one's off. Good box out by Buchanan on Morrill. Coming in is Smith. Almost got his first basket of his last game. No whistle, and the ball just rattled out. Here comes Schultes for three, top of the key. Good boxing out by every Warriors. There wasn't a purple and silver shirt anywhere inside the perimeter. Gill lobbing it over to Smith on the left wing. And then a whistle. Mike Hardy with the call. That's going to go against George Johnson, his first. The second team foul on the Mustangs. As Morrow takes a seat in his place is Charlie Durin. Smith being guarded by Durin. Over to Gill, dangerous pass with Johnson guarding him. They get under the basket at Wells Davis into the corner. Helsby for three. That one rattles off. And a good play by Buchanan to grab it for a second. But the ball goes out of bounds off Dooley. And Denham Buchanan has been a force down low. Coach Francis says that he needs his perimeter players to play a great game, not just Brendan Smith, and he's expecting to see some good things from Denham Buchanan and Wells Davis. So far, they've been cold from the field, and Brendan Smith has the ball slip out of his hands. Turnover for the Warriors. 6 minutes, 8 seconds to go in the first quarter. The game's knotted up at two. Druin over to Henderson, stolen by Gill, slicing and dicing through the defense, but his lay-in attempt's a little too strong. Maybe a little too fancy on the slow motion move in. As Druin got it inside into Spiritus, outside to Dooley, then into Johnson. Spiritus over to Henderson, the shot's well short. Then Buchanan, Wells Davis, as Wells Davis hopping around under the basket, finally gets his second putback to fall. And a nice play by Buchanan, but there's a great example of players that don't play all the time, because Denham was a little more comfortable with Wells. He probably knew he could have just done the alley-oop. But instead he kind of gave an in-between pass, not quite high enough for an alley-oop, not quite low enough to let Wells sort of decide, still remaining on the ground. Spiritus travels as he tried to cut left and then right past Wells Davis, and it's Warriors ball. Warriors leading 4-2. Dooley takes a seat along with Henderson. Morrow back in, as is Higgins. Spiritus, Higgins, Druin, Morrow on the floor. The Warriors turn the ball over. That's Bridge just into the game. Bounce pass into Morrow. Shot doesn't fall. Helsby grabs the rebound. Quickly up to Gill. Mustangs have numbers here. They get in the corner to Bridge for three. Near corner. That one's just short. As Labote also into the game for the Warriors. Gill tried to pickpocket Johnson, but he was able to hold on to the ball and lay it in. Tying the game at four. 4:25 to go in the first quarter. Wells Davis in rhythm from the near side. Hits that three. That's the first three of the game for the Warriors. And they lead 7-4. Morrow handing it off to Johnson. Into Higgins. Over to Spiritus. Spiritus. Stutter step into the paint. Past Gill. No help came. Lobota had the rebound for a second. And Matt just not able to corral it as Spiritus knocked it off Matt's leg out of bounds. Coach Francis over in the corner having a conversation with Mike Hardy. Schultes will replace Spiritus. And Dooley comes in to replace Druin. 3:54 make that left in the first quarter. Warriors up by three. It's 7-4. Mustangs with possession. Full shot clock. Higgins over to Schultes, who tried to get it into Morrow. Nice play by Globota. Can't get it to fall. Helsby and Globota fighting for the rebound. They then swing it outside to Gill for a three, top of the key. High rainbow down and a fist pump from Gill. Another three, and the Warriors extend their lead to 6 points now. It's 10-4, 3.5 minutes to go in the first quarter. Higgins, bounce pass over to Dooley. Down low. And to Johnson, spinning around on Wells Davis, and Wells tried a swiping block to no avail. Higgins got the ball to fall. Helsby to Gill with 16 on the shot clock. Gill had Davis cutting right underneath the basket, but it's stolen by Higgins. One-on-one with Gill. Nice head fake. Gill grabs his own rebound after the miss, and then we'll pull it back. Savvy move by Gill. 20 seconds on the shot clock after the initial miss. He'll drive in again into the corner. Into Higgins. That was Johnson to Higgins. That shot doesn't go. Loose ball is picked up by Bridge. Players falling over the all over the place. And Bridge, take his time. Wayne to the top of the key into the corner. Wells Davis in rhythm again. Far side. Hits that three. Wells Davis on the season, a 38% free throw shooter. Quinn Henderson about to enter the game, and a whistle away from the play. That'll go against Globota, fighting for position. Down with Van Camp. Henderson replaces, looks like Higgins, pardon me, make that Johnson. So the Mustangs turn the ball over right on the inbound. Higgins, Henderson, Morrow, Dooley on the floor, along with Schultes, as a timeout called by the Mustangs, and that football squad right by the Mustangs bench forces the Mustangs to go sit over in the paint about 18 feet from where they would normally be sitting on the bench. Home court advantage here at the back with the Warriors leading 13-6. Waterloo Warriors men's basketball on SSN Canada, brought to you by the University of Waterloo Athletics Department. GoWarriorsGo.ca for the latest in recreation and varsity athletics at the University of Waterloo. Next webcasts are hockey, men's hockey Friday and Saturday night at the Columbia Ice Field. If you can't make it down to see men's hockey, Windsor Friday night, Saturday night is Lakehead. Tune in to SSNCanada.ca with Adam McGuire. The action starts at 7:30, and then it's women's hockey Sunday night from the ice fields against Guelph. Both the men's and women's hockey teams heading to the playoffs. They wrap up their regular season. 2:27 to go in the first quarter. Warriors up by 7. It's 13-6. Coach Francis said he wanted to see his team come out and play with some fire, with some intensity here in the last home day to the regular season, and especially play for the big number 14 of the Warriors in his last home game at the Pack, Brendan Smith. Gill down to Globota by himself. He waited for the defender. The right hook gets it to go. Warriors as a team shooting 42% from the field, 5 of 12. The Mustangs just 3 of 13 for 23%. And then a hard foul down low on Quinn Henderson. Goes against Bridge. Warriors up 15-6, 2:03 to go in the first quarter. Henderson is at the line. His first shot is off the front of the iron, the back, the glass, and then in. Henderson on the season, just a 48% free throw shooter at 13 of 27. Make that now 15 of 29. Gill lobs it over to Buchanan, down to Globota. Wanted to get it up to Gill. Instead, it's stolen and jammed home by Ryan Higgins. Warriors lead now by just 5. It's 15 to 10. And then a pushing foul on Greg Morrow on Bridge. That'll be the third team foul on the Mustangs. Buchanan replaced by Wells Davis, who had been replaced by Bridge. So Buchanan and Bridge take a seat. Helsby and Wells Davis in. So the Warriors with Gill, Helsby, from the Zach Angelini, Globota, and Wells Davis. And That ball goes out of bounds. It looked like from our vantage point, Jordan Johnson of the Mustangs knocked out of bounds. But the official right there says, nope, it went off of Gill. 90 seconds to go in the first quarter. Quinn Henderson into George Johnson for the Mustangs. Hands it off to Dooley. Dooley over to Henderson into Higgins. Higgins into Henderson, who has this pass intended for Johnson, knocked out of bounds by the Warriors. And with five on the shot clock, Mustangs bench communicating that to the players on the court. Brendan Smith will replace Quiboda. 1:16 to go in the first quarter. Warriors up by five. They inbound it. Down into Higgins. Two on the shot clock. Gets past Wells Davis. Instigated some contact. No whistle. The shot missed, and Helsby came down with the rebound. And Mike pushes the ball down the court. Bounces it over to Davis. Dooley right in his face as Davis has made two from long range. That one's a bit strong. And Brendan Smith had almost too good position on Schultes. As Schultes, the rebound went a little bit further behind him as George Johnson makes a three, bringing the Mustangs within two. It's 15-13. Warriors had a 7-point lead before that timeout. Gill has it nearly stolen by Henderson. 26.3 seconds to go in the quarter. 8 on the shot clock with Gill inbounding. George Johnson not giving him the left side. He gets it anyways. As a pushing foul called against Higgins on Helsby, who is driving the baseline. That's the fourth team foul on the Mustangs. 24.1 seconds to go in the quarter. Spiritus comes in along with Druin, replacing Higgins. And George Johnson. Angelini will inbound. Warriors with Smith, Angelini, Helsby, Gill, and Wells Davis on the floor. Angelini lobs it way up top to Smith, who hands it off to Helsby. As the Mustangs having some trouble getting around, and Angelini's shot, not really contested, was a bit strong from the near side perimeter. Schultes tried to drive in. Help came, and then he gives the ball away. Wanted to get to Spritus. Over to Helsby. Into Gill. Lays it in as time was expiring. Smith over to Angelini as time expires, and Zach just didn't realize how much time is left, and that may have been a result of, we've mentioned it before in the second half of the season, temporary scoreboard and the direction the Warriors were heading. That scoreboard is not operational, and there was no shot clock for the Warriors. So after one quarter of play, the Warriors led by as much as 7 in the first quarter. They now lead by just 2. It's 15-13. We'll take a break. You're watching Warriors men's basketball on SSN Canada. On the campus of the University of Waterloo, I'm Sam Charles. You're watching Warriors men's basketball on SSN Canada. It's seniors night here at the Pack, the final home game of the career of Brendan Smith. We've mentioned that Coach Francis is saying that he's expecting and wants his squad to focus in on Brendan and give Brendan a good opportunity, a farewell to the pack. Warriors still with three games remaining on the season. Saturday, it's at McMaster. Wednesday at Brock, and they wrap up the regular season at Guelph. Some tough matchups for the Warriors, but they still have a good shot at the playoffs with a little bit of help from some opponents. But it's really in their hands. They don't necessarily need to win out, but they need to get pretty close to winning out with some help. Gill falls down, still managed to get to Angelini, 10 on the shot clock. Over to Helsby, bounce pass into Smith with Schultes. Turnaround jumper is right over Schultes and good. And that's a play that Brennan, his first year, second year even, when he was just a scrawny big 6'7 BC-er, wouldn't have made, is coming out of nowhere with Schultes. Schultes, the co-captain, he's a wily veteran, according to his coach. Proven scorer, and he runs this offense. Mustangs really missing the graduated playing of Ryan Barbeau, an offensive void. He not just provided that offensive output, he also was a leader, 1,000 career points as a Mustang. And we're reminded by Associate Athletic Director Christine Stapleton and Pazier Kamroper also monitoring our switcher. We will get back to that in a moment. George Johnson to the corner. That shot's strong. Hands it off to Higgins. And Higgins is foul and will go to the line to shoot two. Warriors up against number 14, Smith. 8:46 to go in the first half. Warriors up by two, 17-15, but here's Higgins at the line to try to knock this one up. Higgins, a 67% free throw shooter. He's 16-24 on the season. And he makes the first. It's been all Mustangs in the last 12 games. 3 of 9 against the Warriors. 2 of 3 at home. The Warriors have a record of 2-3 in those 12 games, and 1-6 on the road. As Wells Davis gets it over to Helsby. But the Warriors on a one-game winning streak. Gill from the corner for three. That's a bit short. Angelini grabs the rebound and good presence of mind in the air to get it over to Gill. Over to Angelini. But an offensive foul called as Gill tried to draw a foul from the defender and ran into him instead. So out is Druin. Back in is George Johnson. .8:24 to go. The game's knotted up at 17, and Higgins will inbound. Warriors press just a little bit, making it a little more difficult for this young Mustangs team as Higgins pulls up at the elbow. That shot's too strong. Helsby with the rebound. Gill up to Helsby, to the left wing and to Buchanan, one-on-one with Higgins. Buchanan will back good up to the top of the key. He'll drive in. Jumper doesn't go. Angelini under the basket with the loose ball pickup. Can't get the ball to drop, but Zach will get to the line. Zach on the season, pretty proficient, 79% shooter from the charity stripe. Spritis comes in, replacing Schultes. Higgins out as well. In is Druin again. That foul going against Higgins, that'll be his second. Angelini trying to give the Warriors a lead. Makes the first. We mentioned low scoring game to start off, and then the Warriors caught fire from long range as Angelini makes both. Jumped out to that 7-point lead, but then have let the Mustangs come back into the ballgame. Spiritus into Quinn. Quinn Henderson gets it over to Dooley, hands it back over to Henderson, to the near side to Johnson, into Druin. Back over to Johnson, into the corner for Dooley. Well contested by Mike Helsby, but Dooley makes the three ball. Dooley on the season, a 43% free throw shooter, as Buchanan tried to answer back. Wells Davis with a nice rebound right over Druin. Bounce pass up to Angelini, then over to Giel. 18 on the shot clock. Giel will come to his left. He'll put up a three ball. That one's just off. Angelini with some nice position down low. Grabs the rebound. Outside to Helsby. Back over to Angelini. Double teamed. Over to Buchanan. Denham Buchanan. Shots a bit too strong from just inside the perimeter. And Quinn Henderson grabbed the rebound. Warriors shot 43% in the first quarter. Sporitis trying to drive in. Well defended by Angelini. Forcing him to hand it off to Druin. Right around Giel. And a nice finish by Druin. 22-19, Warriors trail, 6:40 to go in the first half. Buchanan from the near side to the right wing. Into Giel, back over Buchanan. Wide open look from the left wing. That one's just off. Helsby grabbed the rebound somehow, being held by Druin. The Druin grabbed the loose ball over to Henderson to Johnson. Pull-up jumper from about 9 feet. That one falls. Warriors trail now by five. It's 24-19. Giel lobs it over to the near side into Buchanan. Bounces it over to Giel, who wasn't ready for it. Saved it from going out of bounds and gets it into the corner. And Helsby over to Buchanan. Drives in. Little teardrop doesn't fall. And an offensive foul called against Denham. Tough call. He was contorting his body to get around the defender. Hutchcroft will come into the game along with Danico, Jack Danico, a first-year player. Hutchcroft, a first-year player for the Mustangs. And we mentioned, very young squad. Nice pass, threading the needle with Dooley right in to Spritus, who finishes with the left-handed lay-in. 5:40 to go. Dangerous pass from Giel to Helsby. Helsby to the right wing into Wells Davis. Hits the three, and there was an argument there that he was fouled, too. Definitely some contact from Doolin. Wells Davis now 2 of 3 from long range. I think these stats aren't right up to date. I believe that's now 3 of 4. Ben Davis with the new hairdo just into the game for the Warriors. The buzz cut. The foul down low. And that foul is going to go against Buchanan as Brendan Smith about to come back into the game for the Warriors. He'll replace Buchanan. Warriors will go a little bit taller. Hutchcroft is at the line. First year man in kinesiology at Western out of Whitby. Misses the first one badly. His first trip to the line this season. He's been averaging about 10 minutes a game and has seen action in six games for the Mustangs. Less than 5 minutes to go. In the second quarter, Helsby to Ben Davis. And then a push call by the reaction of George Johnson. That's going to go against him. That's the second team, pardon me, the fifth team foul on, I believe it's the second team foul on the Mustangs as we're just waiting to see the scoreboard updated. Second one on Johnson. Schultes takes a seat. Giel into the corner to Angelini. Thought about his shot. Then over to the left wing and Helsby. He'll drive in. Creates some contact, turns it back, and still manages to position himself to easily bank it off the glass and in. Warriors trail by three now. It's 27-24. Quinn Henderson into Danico. Danico pulls up and has it blocked by Giel. Banked it right off of Hutchcroft, who can't make the shot fall. Henderson is up with a follow. That doesn't fall, but Henderson will go to the line to shoot two. Great block by Giel But he really had, it was a no man's land in the air as he caught the block, but there were just purple shirts under the basket. Wells Davis with 11 points so far in his 15 minutes, the leading scorer in the ballgame. George Johnson with 9 points for the Mustangs as Henderson makes his first. Henderson now with 3 points, 3 rebounds in his 12 minutes. Henderson, a third-year player, co-captain along with Schultes. Coach Campbell of the Mustangs calls him the best defender, always takes the toughest matchup. Real glue guy for them. Gill saves it from going out of bounds. Henderson last year won the Purple Heart Award for the Mustangs. And a travel violation called on Hutchcroft, so it'll be Warriors ball. 8 on the shot clock. Charlie Druin make that, comes back into the game. He'll replace Schultes. Looks like Schultes may have a nosebleed. And the Warriors call a timeout to allow for some time to clean up the paint. Warriors trail. Warriors shot pretty well, above 40% in the first quarter. Dropped down a little bit now, 9 of 24 from the field, 4 of 13. The Mustangs are 10 of 26. Probably the Warriors 9 of 24 for 38%. The Mustangs 10 of 24 for 40%. The Warriors 31% from long range, 4 of 13. The Mustangs at 33%, 2 of 6. Warriors being out-rebounded as a team, 15 to 13, and the turnovers are about even. 8 for the Mustangs, 9 for the Warriors. Warriors with Wells, Davis, Brendan Smith, Jaspreet Gill, Mike Helsby, and Zach Angelini with just under 4 minutes here in the first half. Mustangs countering with Hutchcroft, Dooley, Druin, Quinn, and Spritis. Gill somehow wrapped his wrapped himself around the paint and found Helsby on the right wing, who nails the three. Warriors down by 2, 29-27, with 3 minutes 42 seconds to go in the second half. Henderson into the paint, pull-up jumper just inside the line. Good rebound by Hutchcroft. The hook doesn't go. Smith with the rebound quickly up to Gill. On a 3-on-3 has Helsby and Wells Davis on the far side. Gill fighting his way into the paint. Good contest from Dooley, and Jaspreet banked off the bottom of the glass right to a Mustang. Spritis bounces it to the perimeter, still on the perimeter. Into Druin, who hands it off to Dooley. Bounces it into Henderson for 3. That one's short. Long rebound picked up by Hutchcroft. Fresh shot clock for the Mustangs. Dooley has the ball stripped from behind by Gill, but it gets right into the hands of Druin, who missed the first one. The left hook, that one misses, and Smith grabs the rebound finally, and you can really see how the Warriors are missing Kerry Coleman's rebounding in the paint. No one's coming to help Brendan Smith in here in his final home date at the pack. Third team foul on the Mustangs. Missed the call, just looking for an update from the scoreboard, and none coming as Angelini bounces it into Helsby. And Spritis grabbed it, and then Zach couldn't corral it. Zach had it for a moment, it goes out of bounds. Mustangs ball. So nothing really going the Warriors' direction here in the second quarter. You missed the earlier game, the women's game. The Mustangs easily dealt with the Warriors, 73-30. The Mustangs improving to 10-8. That's the women Mustangs. The Warrior women dropping to 0-18 on a 37-game losing streak. Dooley, the two small men in the paint. Nice pass along the baseline. It's Spritis who travels as he was deciding to drive baseline. So the Warriors have an opportunity to pull even, maybe take a little bit of a lead here with 2:19 to go. They trail 29-27. Helsby to the far side of the perimeter to Angelini. Bounces it over to Smith, well out in the flat. Double team comes to trap him in the corner. Nearly coughs the ball up over to Gill. And to Wells Davis into the corner to Helsby by himself. Gets himself set. And the fourth year man, played 3 years in Memorial, makes no mistake with a swish from the near side, giving the Warriors a lead once again, 30-29. The Mustangs nearly turn it over. Dooley tried to get over Spritus. As Schultes takes a seat. Schultes has not played all that much. He's just had a bleeding nose. He's played just 9 minutes of the first half. There, Mustangs expecting some big things from their primary score. Schultes into the paint. Nice pass. And a nice finish by Hutchcroft down low. Schultes clearly a playmaker. Wells Davis spinning around into the paint. Loses the handle of the ball. Grabs it again. But he's fouled. That foul looks like it goes against Hutchcroft. That's the first on Hutchcroft. The fourth on the Mustangs. Warriors with five team fouls already. 91 seconds to go in the first half. Warriors trailing by one. It's 31-30. Helsby being guarded closely by Spritus. Gets it to Angelini. Had it knocked away for a moment, but Zach grabbed it again. Six on the shot clock. Five on the shot clock. Helsby into Angelini. Stolen by Quinn Henderson. Gets it over to Schultes. The two co-captains, Schultes lobbing it into Hutchcroft, had it knocked away by the smaller Gill. And Gill doing some yeoman's work down in the paint, but he wasn't able to corral that one either. Henderson into Hutchcroft, facing up on Smith. Back over to Henderson, gets past his initial check. Smith with a good contest. Angelini down with it, less than a minute to go in the first half. Gill with little hesitation, then he went to his left and then pulled it back over to Angelini by himself. Looked like he wanted to get it over to Smith as three Mustangs converged right at Angelini, and Zach had no option but to bank it off their leg out of bounds. A timeout is called on the floor. 46.6 seconds to go in the first half. Warriors trailing 31-30. You're watching Warriors men's basketball on SSN.
Never say die. I promise never always keep. My heart is racing. I'm getting ready for the world. I've started pacing. I'm ready to settle the score. Pushing in the air. The enemy in front of me. I am a warrior. Glory will be mine. I'm going to shine. Just wait and see.
Back here at the Pack on the campus of the University of Waterloo, you're watching Waterloo Warriors basketball on SSN. As the timeout huddles break up, at least on the Warriors side, the Mustangs still trying to get away from those drumming, the drum squad here of the University of Waterloo football squad, getting quite the rhythm going, quite a percussion ensemble. 46.6 seconds to go in the first half, and the Warriors trailing by a point, 31-30. Helsby got it into Angelini, somehow on his knees managed to corral it and get it back over to Helsby, backing in on Spritus. Eight on the shot clock. Quick move to his right. The shot rattles around, does not fall. Smith with the rebound and the putback. Brandon Smith, encircled with purple shirt, still managed to grab it and get the shot off and in. Warriors up now, 32-31. Spritus into Schultes on the right wing. Well off on the perimeter. But Francis, as he puts up a three ball, that one's well short. And landing on the baseline, wait to see the number, is Quinn Henderson. will be Warriors ball. No shot clock now with just 13 and a half seconds to go in the first half. And the Warriors look to extend their one-point lead. Gill gets it over midcourt. Uses a screen from Smith, driving in, laying it in from the left side, but it's a bit short under the iron. 3 seconds to go. Schultes will put up a three, and that's nothing but air as time expires. And at the half, the Warriors lead 32-31. The Warriors, however, have let it slip. They had a seven-point lead in that first quarter, let it slip a bit, and will head to the locker room up 32-31. But if you look back at the game back in early January at Alumni Hall in London, Warriors trailed at the half 41-34. So it's a defensive matchup that bodes well for the Warriors. And we'll see how things round themselves out here and as we approach the second half. But we will take a break in the meantime, hoping to get an interview with one of Brendan Smith's parents in our second half. You won't want to miss that, as well as some interviews with some other Warriors here at the half, and we'll have stats for you as well. You're watching Warriors men's basketball on SSN.
I am a warrior, a day of reckoning.
there at the pack on the campus of the University of Waterloo. Just had a little visit from John McIntyre, the father of Cam McIntyre, and about this time last year, it was Cam's last home game, and also the last home game for Coach Kieswetter, who retired after last season, and so he came up to chat and had a nice conversation with him, and we're looking forward to having Ron Smith join us in the third quarter. That's the dad of Brendan Smith, just like we had John McIntyre come and chat with us in the third or fourth quarter when in Cam's last game in the black and gold. Warriors up in this one, 32-31, shooting 40% from the field and also 40% from long range as a team. Mustangs having a cooler night from the field, 32% from the field, 22% from long range, 7 of 8 from the charity stripe. Warriors are a perfect 2 of 2 from the charity stripe. Warriors being led by Wells Davis, 3 of 4 from long range, 11 points, 2 rebounds, 2 assists, 1 turnover in his 19 minutes. Mike Helsby with 8 points, 5 rebounds, 2 of 3 from long range. He had 3 assists, 2 turnovers and a steal in his 19 minutes. Jaspreet Gill with 5 points, 1 of 6 from the field. But that one is a 3-ball, and he was perfect from the charity stripe. Has turned the ball over 5 times and had a bunch of near steals, but those don't count on the score sheet in his 20 minutes of play. Brendan Smith in his final game in the black and gold here at the pack with 4 points, 2 rebounds, 2 of 4 from the field. Tried a 3-ball. It didn't go in. 1 turnover in his 12 minutes. Loboda and Buchanan with 2 points apiece rounding out the Warriors scoring. Warriors are being out-rebounded as a team 20-17. The Mustangs being led by George Johnson's 9 points, 1 rebound, 4 of 6 from the field in his 12 minutes. Higgins and Henderson with 4 points, 3 rebounds each. Van Camp with 3 points and 6 rebounds. Van Camp wearing... We had him as number 11. We'll clarify that because we also had him down as he was going to be number 11 today. He's actually number 6 as a clarification there. So that's Van Camp number 6 with his 3.6 rebounds in his 6 minutes. Dooley with 3.2 rebounds. And rounding out the Mustangs scoring, Charlie Druin with 2 and Anthony Spritis with 2 points. In his 11 minutes, Warriors up 32-31. Earlier this season, we sat down with Coach Francis in his first season as the head coach of the University of Waterloo. We found out a little more about his background and what brought him to the University of Waterloo.
Hi, my name is Greg Francis, and I came to the University of Waterloo because I know the tradition, and I want to keep that tradition going and make it, put my own stamp on it. With a lot of the guys that I've played with over the years, we used to start playing basketball a little bit later in the 80s and the 90s. You know, whether it's grade 7 or 8, we would start playing, and I was fortunate enough to have probably one of the best high school coaches in the game, Terry Thompson, at Oakwood. He was able to teach me a lot of fundamentals, and it helped me as a player, but as well now that I'm a coach, it helps me even more because he was a great teacher of the game, and I draw on a lot of experience that I had with him in my coaching every day. My high school coach didn't necessarily want me to go to the U.S. He said, Greg, you can get a great education in Canada. He knew some of the coaches in Canada, some of the players, and I really trusted my high school coach, so... whatever Terry was telling me to look at, I was looking at going to schools in Canada. But he met my college coach on a visit. He came up to the school, and they were very similar. They both played the same sort of Indiana motion style, very cerebral game. And so my high school coach had a comfort level with him that was infectious. So I had that same comfort level. And one of my teammates from the provincial team went to the same Fairfield University. So when I went for my visit, it was very comfortable, and I went there. I was very excited about going there, and I enjoyed it all my years there. I would like to think that they were saying I was a cerebral player, pretty skilled, but when I'm playing against somebody and competing against them, a lot of times people would just tell me I was kind of slow, and they don't understand why I'm scoring so much. So I wanted to use a mix of using team tactics as well as using my own physical preparation for the game. But I felt like when I was in my most tough basketball situations, it helped me more to use my head more than my body to be successful. Some people say the best coaches are people that had some severe type of limit on the court. Because to be a good player, if you're not a great athlete, you had to rely on something other than physical ability or a certain talent. So if you have to use your head, but maybe you're slow or you're fat, I don't know what it could be, but you'll find other ways to compensate. And I think there was times, especially at the higher levels, I had to compensate by using my head in certain situations because my physicality wasn't enough to play at the highest level, whether it's internationally or in university. You know, the toughest thing about CIS head coaching is the administrative side of it. It's you're really running a little organization, and there goes in a lot with whether it's the academic side, recruiting side, scheduling side. That it's a lot of behind the scene things that need to take place to be successful at the CIS level. So I learned a lot about that the hard way at University of Alberta. I had to teach as well. But I'm very thankful for those experiences because those are the things that give you a chance to have success when you're on the basketball court. If you do a good job off the court and get the right players in your program and give them a situation where they can be successful. What I can't tell you everything, but we focus on developing our athletes. I think to have a great team, you have to really increase the skill set of your players. You have to have a team chemistry, but most of the players that you'll see out there, if they don't have the skills, then they can't execute the best team tactics. So we spend a lot of time every day working on the individual skill sets of our players so that when it's game time and we need to make tactical adjustments, they're skilled enough to execute. With both universities, I mean, they're great academic institutions, and I think they're great jobs in compared to the rest of the country. So that's why coaches will go there and stay for an extra long time. Alberta was a great situation, but for me geographically, it made sense for me to look at the situation in Waterloo. And when I had a chance to come here and see some of the administration here, it was a no-brainer for me to make that move, even though there were some positive aspects to Alberta. But Waterloo was a no-brainer for me once I came down and had my visit and had a chance to meet everybody involved. I said, if I can bring players out to Alberta, I'm sure I can bring good players to Waterloo as well.
And there you have it. Coach Francis telling us a little bit about his background. He took over for Don Horwood at the University of Alberta and took those Golden Bears all the way to the CIS final last season, where they ended up losing in that ball game. But just hoping to do the same sort of a transition. Horwood left Coach Francis with a little better situation, a lot of returning experienced players. And Coach Francis and the coaching staff have really had to bring in a lot of players this season. Charlie Upshaw, Chuck McMahon have worked very diligently with the recruitment, brought in a lot of new faces, and takes time for young players to adjust. You can see that on the women's side, certainly, with the young players trying to make that transition to the university game. It's not as simple as it might look. It becomes a lot more complex, a lot more skill is required, understanding of the game of basketball, the basketball IQ, and you need to gel as a team, as individuals, and it's tough, along with focusing on all the other things that a student athlete needs to focus on. As Coach Francis mentioned, University of Waterloo, known as an academic institution, and athletics do come secondary, and that's an important thing for all student athletes to remember, is it is about school first, and a diploma from University of Waterloo means a great deal in the workforce these days. And so all his players understand that, and as much as he wants to have a winning squad, it's equally important that he wants to have a lot of very talented academic students as well. Just about wrapping up our halftime. This will be the last half on home court for Brendan Smith as a member of the University of Waterloo And as a member of the CIS on the home court final half, Smith in that first half played 12 minutes, had 4 points and 2 rebounds. Sort of gotten progressively better every season. In his first season, the scrawny 6'7 forward had 1.5 points a game. And then the next season, 1.7, and then he got up to 8.5 points, almost 9 points last season, and this season at about 5.5 points. But having to share some of the workload, Schultes for three. That one rattles out, and Smith soars through the air to grab the rebound, and it's knocked out of bounds by Dooley. Warriors starting the second half with Denon Buchanan, Wells Davis, Brendan Smith, Jasper Gill, and Mike Helsby. Schultes, Higgins, Dooley, Morrow, and Henderson on the floor for the Mustangs. Buchanan into Smith. One-on-one with Schultes outside to Helsby. Back over to Smith. Double teamed up top to Helsby for a three. Top of the key, and that'll sift the crowd down, as is the tradition. Everyone was up waiting for the first point from the field, and it comes 45 seconds into the second half for the Warriors. They now lead 35-31. Dooley into Morrow. He'll drive, trying to get past Helsby. Has it stolen, the pass intended for Schultes by Smith. Over to Gill. Gill bounce pass into Smith, who tried to jam it home, but he's fouled. And the Warriors bench were on their feet, waiting to just explode, cheering on their fifth-year man, Brendan Smith. But instead, he goes to the line to shoot two. Smith on the season, having some difficulties from the charity stripe, and he misses that one. It's just a laser beam at the iron, went off the front and the back of the iron and the glass and out, averaging 48% from the field, now 14 of 30 on the season. That one's even worse. Gill grabs the rebound, however. Smallest man in the paint, trying to get past the double team, up to Buchanan. Denham gets Wells to come towards him, hands it off to Wells. Wells trying to use a screen from Smith, bounces it over to Smith, top of the key being guarded by Schultes. Hands it over to Buchanan, trying to penetrate. To the corner, into Wells Davis, and then a blocking foul. He is going to go against Higgins. That'll be the first team foul on the Mustangs. And for Higgins, that'll be his third. According to the stat sheet, that's his fourth, so he'll take a seat. The inbound pass into Gill, who loses the handle. George Johnson into the game for the Mustangs. It's Gill with some slippery hands today. Jess Free with 5 points. But he also had 4 turnovers in the first half. Schultes at the charity stripe, pulled it down, spinning around outside into Johnson. He'll drive into the paint. Bounces it over to Dooley, tries the reverse around Smith, and that one drops off the glass. It's a 2-point lead for the Warriors. Gill, right under the basket, into Wells Davis, who's trying to be a little too fancy down below, but he's there to get the foot back. And Wells has some serious jumps. Wants some entertaining basketball on YouTube. Look up Wells Davis. There are some incredible, it's a double dribble by Dooley, some incredible dunks by Wells Davis in his high school days. Helsby. Gets it over to Wells Davis. Into Gill, lob pass to Smith, backing up outside to Buchanan. He'll drive in the little floater. That doesn't fall. Denham tried to bank it to the perimeter, but instead George Johnson grabs it. He'll go end to end and lay it in, despite the fact that Brendan Smith was a nice contestant. We're thrilled to have Brendan's dad, Ron Smith, come and join us up here. And how's it feel for you to be watching your son in his last home game for the Warriors?
So, great to be here. We were here earlier, but after the last game, it was great.
Now, Brendan, you guys live in Kamloops. It's a long way to go for school. Why did he decide to come to Waterloo?
He wanted the nanotech program, and so he came for that.
And he's traveled all around the world, of course, because he spent half a season in Australia as well. How did he enjoy that experience?
That was Austria.
Oh, Austria, pardon me.
But he's been to Australia too. he loved that, and it gave him a lot of good experience. Unfortunately, he had to miss some of the season last year.
What sort of impact has basketball had on Brendan's career?
It's given him a lot of focus and time management. I mean, you have to when you play any of these guys. They need that time management and focus. Take so much of their time just to do this and excel at school too.
Now I know that that Brendan has some grandparents that are maybe watching the webcast right now. Do you want to say a shout out to them?
Well, maybe I will say hello to Jack and Marguerite Hill from White Rock, PC.
Beautiful White Rock. I've worked in Vancouver for quite a while, and I miss it a great deal. And for Brendan, what has he thought of Waterloo? Has he enjoyed the experience overall?
He's loved it. You never really can tell until you leave it and you don't play anymore, but I think that he really likes it. He's enjoyed his time here.
So for your wife and yourself, has it been tough to have your son so far away as they're in school?
Well, you know, how far they go away, you have to travel to see them and that, SSN has been great because we can see them through SSN every Wednesday and Saturday.
That's fantastic.
It is.
Wells Davis, inbound pass into Devin Buchanan, and then an offensive foul. Looks like it's going to go against Angelini, trying to set a screen for Helsby at the top of the field. And I'll let you get back court side to take in the last 16 minutes of pack excitement for Brendan and your family. And congratulations and thanks for your support for the Waterloo Warriors program.
It is certainly more exciting being here than listening to SSN. Yes, it sounds great to see you.
I'll try to bring up the enthusiasm. There you go. Thank you very much. Ron Smith joining us, the father of Brendan Smith. And here, traveling from BC to take in the last home game for his son as a member of the University of Waterloo Warriors. Wells Davis, nice pass over to Gill, near side for three. That one's just short. Angelini banks it out to Helsby. Fresh shot clock. Warriors trailing now, 39-37. Davis into the paint, got in trouble, managed to find Angelini is an out, over to Helsby for three, top of the key, and he nailed it. 40-39, the Warriors lead. Seesaw matchup between these two teams. At the bottom of the OUA West, both teams mathematically still in the hunt for a playoff spot. Quinn Henderson uses the screen for Schultes. The switch is made by the Warriors. Henderson getting it down into Druin, and the shot clock expires. Good defensive stand by the Warriors. Mac Labota comes in to replace Zach Angelini. 5 minutes, 2 seconds to go in the third quarter. The Mustangs with four team fouls already. The Warriors with just one. So the Warriors, if they can get some good dribble penetration, maybe get some free shots in the latter half of this third quarter. Nice touch pass from Wells Davis, who travels as he stepped on the ankle of Schultes. As Dooley comes in, he'll replace Schultes. Coach Francis with some words for Mike Hardy down at the baseline, wanting to know exactly how one travels by stepping on. And there's another travel. So there's the experience of Coach Francis, maybe not in the OUA, but certainly in the CIS. But a little bug in the officials here, and won't necessarily get the call every time, but maybe down the road. That one was a very close call there in terms of the timing. You'll get a call. Coach Francis, an assistant on the Canadian senior men's national team under Jay Triano. Nice fadeaway J by Wells Davis. Pardon me, by Mike Helsby. Warriors up now, 42-39. 4.5 minutes to go. Henderson gets it from the far side, driving in, puts up a shot, that one short. And then a blocking foul called against Denham Buchanan, just not quite there in time. Denham sporting those fluorescent yellow shoes. That's the third foul on Denham, the second foul on the Warriors as a team. And Quinn Henderson will go to the line. Henderson, 48% free throw shooter. For shots up and around and in. Warriors led 15-13 after one quarter. And then 32-31 after at the half. Henderson makes both and brings the Mustangs within one. It's 42-41, and he's then replaced by Peter Schultes. Mustangs said they needed to do a good job on the glass tonight against the Warriors. They need to score. Nice pass down low from Gill into Buchanan, who finishes with the reverse under the basket. And the Mustangs are out rebounding the Warriors, 24-22. Long shot by Morrow is off. As Buchanan and Gill go end to end, and a behind the back pass from Gill. He was really out of position there, wanting to give it back to Buchanan, something we haven't necessarily seen from Gill. And a rejection by Wells Davis. Helsby picked up the loose ball, up to Buchanan. And Gill being unselfish, trying to find Buchanan. And then a whistle on the floor as it looked like Morrow came down awkwardly. It looks like a wrist injury by the way that he's holding on to his arm. Pardon me, that's Druin, Charlie Druin. Maybe not a wrist, maybe a finger or more specifically perhaps the thumb. Looks like on the right hand. Try to get an update for you if we can. Warriors up by three. It's 44-41 in the last home game of the 2012-2013 regular season. Last home game. It's seniors night. Last home game for Brendan Smith. And we again thank his dad, Ron Smith, for joining us up here at our webcast location. Julie with a nice move going end to end, and the Warriors just sort of let him go, and he was able to bank it off the glass. Wells Davis gets it over to Buchanan, right wing. Has Henderson right in his face. Double team comes, lobs it down into Gobota. And Matt called on the travel. A little bit of a push in the back from Schultes. But that one was a little more obvious in terms of the walk call by the official. Warriors shooting 43% of the game, 17 of 40. Mustangs, 16 of 43. Leading scorer in the game, Mike Helsby with 16, Wells Davis with 13, George Johnson of the Mustangs with 11. Johnson with the ball, looked like he traveled there. He misses the long rebound. He picks it up himself. Up into Henderson for a three as the shot clock expires. Gill knocks up to Globoda, over to Denham Buchanan. Over to Helsby, who quarterbacks this offense. Back over to Buchanan, back over to Helsby in the corner. He'll go baseline, and then a pushing foul on Morrow. We'll take Helsby to the line. Andrew Van Camp will re-enter the game. He's a first-year player for this squad, number six. Coach Campbell calls him a post with potential. And he replaces Greg Morrow, a second-year man who's just picked up his third foul. Now into penalty are the Mustangs. Warriors up now, 45-43. Helsby with the deep knee bend. Shots up. That one's good. 46-43, 2:41 to go in the third quarter. Warriors lead. Coach Campbell said at the beginning of this season that his team could potentially make the playoffs. He said the OUA West, top to bottom, the toughest conference in the country. And he said his team will be better later in the season, much like last year. Schultes with a nice play. He doesn't get the ball to fall, but he'll go to the line to shoot two. Said if they are able to play well in February, anything can happen. And it's been a slow slide for this Western team. Had a three-game losing streak from against Lakehead and Brock. Defeated Guelph 71-68. Then dropped games to Windsor and McMaster. Neither game terribly close. They lost to Windsor 89-61 and to McMaster 91-59. Two of the better squads in the OUA West, mind you. And it's been very similar seasons for both the Warriors and the Mustangs. Not really being able to do anything with any sort of consistency, whether in the game or in the season. Helsby into the corner. Wells Davis, open look for the far side. That one rattles around and falls. Wells Davis now with four threes. 2 minutes to go in the third quarter. Warriors up by five, 49-44. Dooley hands it over to Schultes. They get it over to George Johnson after the pass from Quinn Henderson. Over to Dooley. Near side, five on the shot clock. To Van Camp, who is hit on the arm and rejected by Jesprit Gill, just mistimed his jump. Gill not having the most proficient offensive evening here at the pack, but playing very well defensively and unselfishly on offense. So his game is already evolving as we go through the second half of the season. Van Camp makes the first. Second one rattles out, and good box out by Helsby. Van Camp on the season, a 58% free throw shooter. And illustrating why right there. Bounce pass to Helsby, and to Kubota with the left hook. That one does not fall. I believe Matt is right-handed, unlike Brendan Smith, who is left-handed, and that left hook, not so easy. George Henderson tried to drive baseline, then gets it up to Schultes, over to Dooley, then over to Quinlan. 11 on the shot clock, into Henderson, wide open look from the left side, as well strong. Wells Davis got there a little bit late, but maybe contested it just enough. Helsby, pull-up jumper from the near elbow, hits it, and he'll go to the line for a three-point play. Wells now with 20 points on his evening. Out-of-town scoreboard, our latest at the half, it was Brock over Laurier, 44-39, no update from the McMaster game. And Wells misses the opportunity for the three-point play. 1 minute to go in the third quarter. Warriors up by six. It's 51-46. Johnson into Schultes, over Dooley, over to Quinlan. And then a holding foul going to be called against Kubota, who has some words for Wells Davis about their switch, forcing Kubota to pick up that foul. Now both teams into the penalty. 54 seconds to go in the quarter as Smith replaces Kubota. That's Kubota's second personal foul. Jesprit Gill with two fouls. Denny Buchanan with three. Angelini and Helsby with two. Schultes makes the first. Schultes on the season, a 71% free throw shooter, and he makes the back end with the nice release, keeping the wrist just so at the charity stripe, bringing his team within four. Warriors up 51-47. Helsby takes his time getting over half court, then he drives in quickly to the corner to Wayne Bridge, in rhythm for three, hits the three! Warriors now 10 of 22 from long range for 45%. Mustangs just 2 of 13 from long range for 15%. Van Camp outside to George Johnson. He'll drive trying to get past Bridge. Well defended by both Smith and Bridge on the play, but it looks like Bridge picks up the foul. Higgins will come in to replace Schultes. The Warriors huddle up. Bridge, that's his second foul. As Johnson, with a head of steam, cutting into the paint, ran right into Bridge and Smith. Johnson, in his first year, joins the team from the London Orion Basketball Club. Makes the back end. He's a two-sport athlete, played football at the University of Western Ontario as a receiver. That's pretty impressive to be able to maintain your grades, play football, very demanding, lots of practicing sport, and then basketball also the same. Pull-up jumper from just where Brandon Smith likes it. About a 14-footer, nothing but net. Dooley will put up a shot as time expires here in the third quarter. And after three quarters of play, the Warriors lead 56-48. Leading the way for the Warriors, Wells Davis with 18, Mike Helsby with 18 points, George Johnson with 12, Peter Schultes with 11. We'll take a break. You're watching Warriors men's basketball on SSS Canada, SSN Canada, here from Waterloo. On the campus of the University of Waterloo, I'm Sam Charles. You're watching University of Waterloo Warriors men's basketball. Leading scorers for the Warriors right now, Mike Helsby, Wells Davis, both with career highs in points so far, and we still have another 10 minutes to go in the ballgame. Wells Davis coming into this game, his most points scored in the game was 13, December 28th at Memorial. And for Mike Helsby, it was 17 points. Those 17 points in two different games, against same game against Memorial, and also January 16th against Laurier. Dooley pressing a little bit as the Warriors inbound it into Bridge. They get it to Helsby and Smith and over to Gill, who has it stolen by George Johnson. Johnson will drive in and drawing a foul on the reach-in by Gill. And Jaspreet, no indication for the bench just yet. That's his third personal foul, the first team foul on the Warriors in the first 15 seconds here in the fourth quarter. And Johnson makes good on the three-point play, bringing his team within five, 56-51. Warriors started off slow, pulled out to a 7-point advantage in the first quarter. Let the Mustangs, as Helsby coughs at the ball, let the Mustangs back into the ball game, led by one at the half. And here we are now with the Warriors up by five with 9:20 to go. All by himself is Quinn Henderson after a nice inbound pass from Dooley, and Henderson makes no mistake, bringing the Mustangs within three. It's now 56-53. Bridge to Helsby. Right wing. Sets himself. Nails the tray from the right wing. And the Warriors on fire from long range. Now as a team, 10, make that 11-23 for 45%. Schultes hands it to Dooley. Dooley will drive in. Bounce it to the corner to Johnson, who had couldn't corral it right away. He'll put up a three, contested all the way by Wayne Bridge, and the air ball gets into the hands of Smith over to Gill. Gill gets right past George Johnson, and he gets the one as the delayed call by Rich Stelic, our lead official this evening. on the continuation, and Gill, a little payback for Johnson just moments ago. And Gill is at the line to shoot two. Gill on the season, an 89% free throw shooter. Makes good, bringing his squad within nine, or pardon me, up by nine, 62-53. Lots of time left as Gill with another pickpocket, but this one, he's the last one to touch it as it goes out of bounds off of Johnson. Johnson lost the ball off of Gill, and so it is Mustang's ball. 17 on the shot clock. Schultes into Dooley. Into Henderson for a three ball. He hits that one. Wells Davis was there. Henderson on the season. A 35% free throw shooter. A three-point shooter. The ball goes off of a Mustang and then picked up by Dooley, who can't get it to drop, but the putback is there by Morrow. Sloppy D by the Warriors as they let the follow player easily corral the rebound. One of the keys for this Mustang squad, control the glass. They haven't quite done that, but it's been close. Gill has his three-ball attempt rattle out. Mustangs wanted to run, and they've really just been playing a half-court offense. Few breaks to get it down into Henderson. Help came too late from Bridge, and he banks it off the glass and in. Just like that, a couple of quick possessions and turnovers by the Warriors, and the Mustangs are within two. Bounce pass to Smith, to Wells Davis to the corner, and Helsby to Gill, right wing for three. That one he hits. Gill now with 11 points, four rebounds, and it's 33 minutes. Johnson will fight his way to the far side. Up to Henderson to Morrow. Nearly had it stolen by Gill. Higgins comes in replacing Morrow. Buchanan comes in replacing Wells Davis. And again, career nights so far for both Wells Davis and Mike Helsby. And there's still 6:49 to go in the quarter. Coach Francis said it was going to be paramount for his perimeter players, both Wells Davis. And he specifically said Denham Buchanan to have strong nights offensively as the shot clock expires. No communication from this young Mustangs team, and head coach Brad Campbell not terribly pleased with the way things are going. Campbell in his sixth year as the head coach of the Mustangs. He was an assistant for 8 years, and he played at the University of Western Ontario. Warriors lead 65-60. You see one of the assistants of the University of Waterloo football squad, Marshall Bingham, also at the game today. Football squad has had lots of announcements recently with recruits. Be another exciting season as the Warriors continue to trek up the standings. We talk about all these young squads coming out of Waterloo Athletics, but those young squads are very soon getting a little more and a little more experience and will start to make some runs for the playoffs, just like men's hockey and women's hockey this year. A reminder that Adam McGuire has men's hockey on SSN Canada. Friday night, men's hockey, 7:30 against Windsor. Saturday night, 7:30 puck drop against Lakehead. And then Sunday, women's hockey against Guelph, also a 7:30 puck drop. You can't make it down to the Columbia Ice Fields, and it's a great atmosphere, just like it is here at the Physical Activities Complex on the campus of the University of Waterloo. Tune in to ssncanada.ca. 6:38 to go in regulation in our final home game of the 2012-2013 season. It was a rough start for the Warriors, as the Warriors started the season 0-9. Before picking up their first victory of the season at Alumni Hall on the campus of the University of Western Ontario, where they down the Mustangs. Helsby gets past his check. Higgins down to Buchanan by himself. Got the defender off his feet, but the official on the baseline said Denham traveled. Smart move by Denham, getting the defender off his feet, drawing what would have been a foul had he been able to control his own feet. Chris Delaney, the official, making the call on the play. Dooley gets past Higgins and getting up to Henderson from the left wing. The long rebound's picked up by Higgins. Higgins over to George Johnson. Johnson coming to the near side. Over to Higgins and then to Henderson. Gets past Buchanan and a rejection by Smith as the Warriors on transition quickly bring it down. Over to Buchanan in the corner. Wayne Bridge waited for the defender to get there and then easily cuts his way to the basket and banks it off the glass, and a timeout called by the Mustangs. As every time the Mustangs inch their way back into this game, the Warriors have an answer and a heads-up play by Wayne Bridge, the veteran Bridge, electing not to go for the three as the defender came out to contest the shot, and he cut his way to the basket hard and banked it off the glass and in. Warriors up by 7, 67-60. We'll take a quick break. You're watching Warriors men's basketball on SSN.
I'm getting ready for the war. I'm starting to face him. I'm ready to settle the score. Ocean in the air, the enemy in front of me. I am a warrior. Glory will be mine. I'm going to shine, just wait and see. I am a warrior. I see a reckoning. I see everything. I know what I'm for. I am a warrior.
Back here at the back on the campus of the University of Waterloo, I'm Sam Charles, along with our game day producer, Hay, and our executive producers, Chris Gilbert and Dan Ackerman. 5:44 to go in this final quarter of regulation. Warriors up by 7, and so far they have not missed the contribution of Kerry Coleman, who before this game tweeted that 1 minute before the tip-off tweeted, feeling useless without basketball right now, ineligible to play, and sitting on the bench cheering on his squad along with John Ravenhorst, who's nursing a groin injury. And we don't have a status on Curry, but unlikely he'll be able to see any game action as the miss by Schultes for the remainder of at least the regular season. Wells Davis from the far side for three. That one's just a bit short. And Morrow came down with the rebound. We approach the midway mark of the fourth quarter. Dangerous pass from Morrow into Schultes, who misses, and Bridge with the rebound for the Warriors. Coach Francis already with the tie-off. Usually gets that tie-off within the first, let's say, 90 seconds of a ball game. Down into Helsby from Bridge, and a great play away from the play, setting some screens. The Warriors run that play to perfection, and Helsby has an easy bank in from right underneath the iron. 4:44 to go in the fourth quarter. Dooley has the ball, looked like kicked by Gill. So 14 on the shot clock as Smith will re-enter the game for the Warriors, and George Johnson replaces Dooley for the Mustangs. Higgins trying to spin around. Gill lost the ball. It's a 4-on-2 for the Warriors. Bridge had it swiped away by George Johnson in the corner, trying to get himself some space. Cross-court pass goes out of bounds and very well defended by George Johnson. Johnson, a first-year player, as we mentioned, out of London Orion Basketball Club. Higgins hands it off to Henderson, over to Johnson, then to Morrow. To Johnson, in rhythm for three, and Wells Davis just didn't get the hand up, had to work his way around the screen. And Johnson nails the three ball. 4 minutes precisely to go in the fourth quarter. Wells Davis lobbing up to Gill. Gill getting into traffic to the far side to Bridge for three. Hits the three to answer back. As we mentioned, the Warriors have had an answer for this Mustangs team all afternoon. And a turnover by the Mustangs. Here's Gill on one-on-one. Nice behind-the-back dribble. And he misses the lay-in from that left side, his natural side, and the foul called against Higgins. That'll take Gill to the line. That's the fifth and disqualifying foul for Higgins. Higgins leaves this game with 4 points, three rebounds in 22 minutes. He's replaced by Dooley. Coach Campbell and the Mustangs telling us before this game that if his Mustang squad could get at least 70 points, they'd have a very good shot of winning this. And they're closing in. They just need seven. They're seven shy with 3.5 minutes to go. Gill on the evening so far, 3 of 10 from the field, 2 of 6 from long range, and he's a perfect 3 of 3 from the charity stripe. He has 1 block and 3 steals, and he would have even had more, but he's turned the ball over a couple of times. Just some slippery hands. Makes the first here. Bringing the team up by 10. Story of the season for the Warriors, it's that inconsistency. They just haven't been able to close out a game with a definitive push, which they will look to do now with 3 minutes, 25 seconds to go. They give Johnson a wide open look. That one rattles out. Smith jumps over top of Dooley to grab the rebound. Helsby with a crossover dribble. Got away from Morrow for a second, then Morrow reaches in. Helsby gets past him again, getting it into Gill by himself under the basket, waiting for the help to come from the teammate of Morrow, leaving Jaspreet Gill by himself, and Jaspreet easily banks it in, and a timeout is called. And this is the sort of push that the Warriors need in order to pull out and sort of show the Warriors faithful and themselves that they have what it takes to be the kind of team that can take a game right out of the hands of an opponent. 76-63, the Warriors lead. Warrior leading scorer at this point, Mike Helsby, with 23 points, 8 rebounds. He also has 5 assists in his 36 minutes. That's a career high for Mike. And for Wells Davis, just behind him, with 18 points, 3 rebounds, 2 assists, 1 block, in his 35 minutes of play. He's played one whale of a game. Jaspreet Gill with 15 points, 5 rebounds, but he's turned the ball over 7 times. We'll take a quick break. You're watching Warriors men's basketball on SSN. Give us like not even 10 minutes. Back here at the pack, we're just having some technical issues with our camera. We'll be back up in line in just a couple of seconds, we hope. Warriors leading 76-63, and an offensive foul called against Schultes. So Schultes driving in from the left side as an outlet pass down into Wells Davis. Here comes Wells, who will try to lay it in. He's fouled by Henderson, and Wells will go to the line. There's some maturity from Wells, who in front of this home crowd could have probably put on a pretty spectacular dunk, but instead elected to just lay it in. Also don't want to put any salt on the wounds for this Mustangs team. You're only up by 13. There's lots of time left. Now I'll make that 14 as Wells makes good on the first. Wells, a 70% free throw shooter on the season. His first time to the line this afternoon, or make that this evening, and he's 16 of 22 on the season so far. George Johnson driving into the near side, outside of Schultes. Smith dived up there. They get it out to Henderson for a three ball. Not sure he called that one from downtown St. Jacobs, but it went off the glass and in. He'll take it. When you're a good three-point shooter, you're going to get those sorts of breaks. And Henderson got one right there. Smith makes that Helsby with a beautiful pass into Bridge, who makes the put in from right under the basket and will go to the line for a three-point play. Beautiful no-look from Helsby to Bridge, and Wayne made no mistake right under the basket, banking it off the glass. Warriors now with 80 points. Wayne Bridge trying to extend that. And he does with the making good on the three-point play. Bridge now with 10 points, 2 rebounds in his 12 minutes. Johnson over to Henderson into Dooley. Has it stripped by Wells Davis, who controls the loose ball and then cleverly banks it back behind him into Helsby. Helsby sees some daylight in the lane, and then he's fouled probably by Morrow, or though Dooley could have also been the guilty party. Morrow. That's the fourth foul on Morrow. Asparagus comes in. Van Camp comes in. And Danico comes in for the Mustangs. Less than 2 minutes to go, and the Warriors are beginning to pull away. Is Helsby uses as much English on that ball as he can. Good thing for the that he's a master's student in the English literature department. So he needed every piece of the iron to have the ball go through the cylinder. That time, makes no mistake, and just uses the net. Right through. 83-66, the Warriors lead. They whistle on the play. It's a foul. See if we can get an update from the out-of-town scoreboard. George Johnson inbounding. Foul going against Gill. That's his fourth. Into the game is Vandervoort. And Vandervoort got it into Van Camp. Nice move with the left hook over Smith, but he missed, and Brendan grabbed the rebound. 90 seconds to go. Warriors up 83-66. The miss by the Warriors. Van Camp came up with it. 1:15 to go. And as long as the Warriors can put up some good defensive stops and an offensive foul, goes against Van Camp, battling down the floor, and you'll assume with Angelini about to come in, he's going to replace Helsby. Helsby, as we mentioned before, a career night for him, 25 points. He twice had 17 points in a game for the Warriors. Smith hands it to Gill. The Warriors get it up to Angelini. They'll just hold it on, try to eat up a bit of the shot clock. Now 60 seconds to go in the ball game. Warriors are going to win this one. Despite missing the shot right there. Loose ball picked up by Bridge. Fight for the loose ball and possession arrow after the jump ball, heading in Mustang's direction. Warriors will improve their record to 4-14. Western will drop to 2-15. Still waiting on an update from our out-of-town scoreboard. Vandervoort into Johnson, spinning around on Bridge. Vandervoort's shot after that loose ball. That doesn't go in. Bridge jumps out of nowhere to grab the rebound. 35 seconds to go. The Warriors outlet pass into Wells Davis, who just slows it down a little bit. looks up at the clock, 29 seconds up there, 13 on the shot clock. Davis goes to the far side. And Angelini, 6 on the shot clock. Wells Davis for 3, that one's a bit strong. Loose ball, and the rebound picked up by Zach Angelini. Over to Smith, over to Wells Davis. Will they get into the hands of Brendan Smith? For the last 7 seconds, nope, they're going to hold on to it. And that's the way that Brendan Smith, who gets the ball as the clock runs out, will end his home experience here at the back with a victory. 83-66, a dominating second half for this Warriors squad. The Warriors, now 83-66 victories. They improved their record, as we mentioned. Brock, with 1 minute to go, is up on Laurier 76-68, and McMaster down Guelph 91-65. So what needed to happen has happened so far. The Warriors win, and some opponents down at the middle to bottom of the OUA West lose, and then that way the Warriors inch their way that much closer. They're a game out of a playoff spot in the OUA West. The player of the game, Mike Helsby, with his 25 points, 8 rebounds. Wells Davis with 20 points, 3 rebounds. Jesprit Gill, 15 points, 5 rebounds. Wayne Bridge, 11 points, 3 rebounds. Brendan Smith, 6 points, 5 rebounds in his final game here at the pack for the Warriors. And rounding out the scoring for the Warriors, Danny Buchanan with 4 points, 3 rebounds, and Mac Labota with 2 points, 1 rebound. Leading scorer for the Mustangs with George Johnson's 18 points, 6 rebounds. Quinn Anderson with 16 points, 4 rebounds. And Schultz with 11 points, 3 rebounds. The leading scorers for the Mustangs. That does it for our season this season. We thank our camera operator today, Pay, and our producers, Dan Ackerman, Chris Gilbert. The associate athletic director is Christine Stapleton. The athletic director of the University of Waterloo Athletics Department is Bob Copeland. I'm Sam Charles. We'll see you next season. You've been watching Warriors men's basketball on SSN Canada. Thanks for watching.